Mom's Mabley Biography. 1894-1975. Mom's Mabley was a trailblazing African-American 20th-century comedian known for warm yet raunchy stand-up routines and hit albums. Who was Mom's Mabley? Mom's Mabley was born in Brevard, North Carolina in the 1890s, and went on to establish a career as the top stand-up comedian of her time. She starred in several films, became a headliner at the Apollo Theater, and in the 1960s had hit comedy albums. She was also a top draw for a number of TV variety shows. She died in New York on May 23, 1975. Comedian Whoopi Goldberg directed a documentary on Mabley's life. Background. The woman who would become known as famed comedian Mom's Mabley was born Loretta Mary Aiken in Brevard, North Carolina, on March 19, 1894, some sources say 1897, to a large family. She experienced a horrifying, traumatic childhood. Her firefighter father was killed in an explosion when she was 11, and her mother was later hit and killed by a truck on Christmas Day. And by the beginning of her teens, Aiken had been raped twice and become pregnant from both encounters, with both children being given away. Becoming Mom's Mabley. Aiken left home at the age of 14 and pursued a show business career, joining the African-American vaudeville circuit as a comedian under the Theater Owners Booking Association. Fellow performer Jack Mabley became her boyfriend for a short time, and she took on his name, becoming Jackie Mabley, with Mom's coming from her eventual reputation as a mentoring, mothering spirit. By the early 1920s, she had begun to work with the duo Butter Beans and Susie, and eventually became an attraction at the Cotton Club. Mabley entered the world of film and stage as well, working with writer Zora Neale Hurston on the 1931 Broadway show Fast and Furious, a colored review in 37 scenes, and taking on a featured role in Paul Robeson's Emperor Jones, 1933. Public versus private persona. Starting in the late 1930s, Mabley became the first woman comedian to be featured at the Apollo, going on to appear on the theater stage more times than any other performer. She returned to the big screen as well with The Big Timers, 1945, Boarding House Blues, 1948, and the musical revue Killer Diller, 1948, which featured Nat King Cole and Butterfly McQueen. Mabley's stand-up routines were riotous affairs, augmented by the aesthetic she presented as being an older, house-dress-clad figure who provided sly commentary on racial bigotry to African-American audiences. Her jokes also pointed towards a lusty zest for younger men. Yet, belying that persona, offstage she had a glamorous, chic look and was known to be a lesbian. Hit albums. Mabley began a recording career with her Chess Records debut album The Funniest Woman Alive, which became gold certified. Subsequent albums like Mom's Mabley at the Playboy Club, Mom's Mabley at the UN and Young Men, See, Old Men, No continued to broaden Mabley's reach. She ultimately recorded many albums. She landed spots on some of the top variety shows of the day, including The Ed Sullivan Show, and graced the stage of Carnegie Hall. Legacy and Whoopi Goldberg film. Mabley had a starring role in the 1974 picture Amazing Grace, which she was able to complete despite having a heart attack during filming. She died on May 23, 1975, in White Plains, New York. Actress Clarice Taylor, who portrayed Bill Cosby's mother on The Cosby Show and was a major fan of Mabley's work, staged the 1987 play Moms at the Astor Place Theater, in which she portrayed the trailblazing icon. More than 20 years later, fellow comedian Whoopi Goldberg made her directorial debut with the documentary Mom's Mabley, I Got Something to Tell You, which was presented at the Tribeca Film Festival and HBO.